This Tracktion Waveform 11 tutorial looks at how to install VST plugins in Tracktion Waveform Free and Waveform Pro on Windows 10. I'm Zane, and on this channel, I do weekly audio tech tips, tutorials, and reviews to help you conquer the tech and unleash your creativity. Now, if you haven't checked out my Tracktion Waveform Free tutorial for beginners, I'll be sure to link to that in the description below so you can check that out after and maybe get a few other tips and tricks. But right now, let's jump into this Waveform 11 tutorial. So first, you'll need some VST plugins to install. I'm going to use a great free plugin from Plugin Boutique called Voltage Nucleus. And I'll also be using MT Power Drum Kit 2, which is a free drum plugin. I'll include links to both of them in the description. Now, one thing to keep in mind is that Waveform 11 is a 64-bit program. So when you're getting new plugins, make sure you get the 64-bit version. Now let's first look at installing MT Power Drum Kit 2. So when you get it, it's going to be in a zip file like this. Double-click on it, and then go into the folder, and you'll see you have some folders and some files in here. I always recommend to read the installation when you see one of these readmes. They're usually pretty quick to read, and they tell you what to do. This one doesn't have an installer. So we have to take this DLL file, and also in the installation it said we also have to move this PDK file into our plugins folder. So just highlight both of them, right click, copy, and then go to your plugins folder. Typically it's C Program Files, VST Plugins. If you have a different plugins folder, use that. If you don't even have a plugins folder yet, you can create this one here. VST plugins in your C program files. That's the typical spot that plugins want to install to. And when you have your folder, you can choose to keep yours a little more organized if you want. You can have them organized by effects, instruments, brand name, whatever you want. And it might make things a little easier to find in Waveform, as Waveform does see these subfolders. So I have one called Free, and that's where I'm going to put this plugin. So then you would just right-click, paste, and you see I have my plugin in there. So if you download a plugin and it doesn't have an installer, but you see a DLL file in there, typically you have to move that DLL file into your VST plugins folder, and always read the installation readme if there is one in there. And some plugins include both the 32-bit and 64-bit version, and they will say 32 and 64 on the DLL file, so make sure you grab the 64-bit one. Now let's look at installing this other plugin. So you would just double-click on it to install it just like any other program, then click Next here, agree to their terms, you might want to read that, click Next, and here you have the option to install the standalone application, so you don't need to install it in your DAW. You could actually just run it on its own. You can choose to install that. You can also choose to install the VST2 plugin and the VST3 plugin. Now, I usually choose to install both of those, and it also gives you the option to install the Pro Tools plugin. I'm not going to install that. I'll just install these two. Click Next, and now it's going to ask you where your VST plugin folder is. And as you can see, it already knows where mine is. So if yours isn't there, you would just click Change and then scroll to wherever your folder is in here. Click OK and then click Next. Make sure everything looks good here. And when you're ready, you would click Next to install. So that's the installation. Now we need to get Waveform 11 to see your plugins. So you'll want to go up to Settings, and then go down to Plugins right here, then click on the Scanning and Sorting button, go to Scan for New or Updated VST Plugins, click on that, and it brings this Select Folders to Scan window up. And you can see I already have my folders in here, and you might have some folders in there as well. If you already have yours in there, you're good to go. If you don't, you want to click on this plus sign here, and then you would navigate to C Program Files, VST Plugins, or whatever your plugin folder might be. And once you're there, click OK, and then you want to click on Scan. And if you see something like this pop up at the end, This usually means you have 32-bit plugins in your plugin folder, or you have it aimed to look at the 32-bit plugin folder, if you have separate ones for that. So if you want Waveform to automatically search for plugins every time you install a new one, go to File Locations, and then in the Plugins section, make sure you have Automatically Check for Newly Added Plugins checked like this. And now every time you install a new plugin, you're going to get a pop-up saying Waveform has detected a new plugin. Would you like to scan it now? You click Scan, and your new plugin's added. Now let's look at using our plugin. So open up a project or create a new project. Then on whatever track you want to use the plugin, go over to this section over here, right-click, click on Add New Plugin, find your plugin folder, and there's my MT Power Drum Kit 2. And if you want to use your MIDI keyboard to control this, you would just click over here. Make sure your MIDI keyboard selected as the input, and now you can control it with your MIDI keyboard. And you can even add effects plugins after your instrument plugin. So you would just right-click there again, go to Add New Plugin, and if your plugin installs before the instrument, you can just click and drag and let go so it comes after the instrument. And now, you have a plugin on the same track, and you can keep adding as many plugins as you like to the list here. Let's also look at the other plugin we installed. So right-click on another track, Add New Plugin, and here's that free Voltage Nucleus plugin that we installed. And this one is huge and it's really cool. I'm going to make another tutorial going into more detail about making music using just virtual instruments. So be sure to watch for that one. If you want even more free VST plugins, click here for 30 of them, or click down here to see what YouTube thinks you should watch next. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Also subscribe to the channel if you'd like to see more videos like this. Thank you so much for watching. For Simple Green Tech, I'm Zane. Keep creating, and we'll talk soon.